What is going on, guys? As I mentioned in the last episode, today I'm going to talk about fintech and my investment ideas for PayPal and Square. Now let's get started. So, what is fintech? Fintech is short for financial technology. Seems simple, right? Well, we have seen advances such as ATMs in the 60s, debit cards in the 70s, online banking in the late 90s. And here we have fintech. In today's increasingly digital world, financial services, one of the largest markets of the economy, remains mostly offline. Fintech refers to the innovative technologies making financial services more efficient, personal, and secure. Well, the term fintech includes a huge range of products, technologies, and business models that are changing the financial services industry. It includes cashless payments, crowdfunding platforms, robo-advisors, virtual currencies. Global investment in the fintech sector has added up to nearly $136 billion in 2019. In 2019 alone, fintech investment surged 21%. Some of the world's largest companies, from Apple to Alibaba, are going big on it too. Just think of Apple Pay or Alipay. Now, let me introduce PayPal, which is the most representative stock of fintech. PayPal has acquired several digital fintechs to expand its product offerings, as shown in the image here. So, let's take a look at each of their business models. First of all, PayPal is basically business-to-customer platform. PayPal makes money primarily by processing customer transactions on the payments platform and from other value-added services. Just like a regular wallet, you can hold cash in there in the form of a PayPal balance. You can have your debit cards and credit cards in there for various banks and credit card providers. You can have all these into your PayPal wallet, and you can make payments. You can choose whichever funding source you'd like to use. Second, PayPal Credit is basically online credit card. It used pretty much almost every single site online. Online store like eBay, Apple, Home Depot, and Adidas have PayPal option. PayPal is more than just a credit card too. PayPal Credit offers your customers the option of no interest if paid in full in 6 months on purchases of $99 or more. Third, Braintree is e-commerce solution for business. Braintree specializes in mobile and web payment systems for e-commerce companies. Braintree is commonly used on online websites to collect credit card payments, as it's a secure method, and it also allows for an on-site checkout. Fourth, Venmo is a social payment service used by millions of people to make and share payments with friends, family, and select approved businesses. This service is popular with the millennial generation. According to ARK's research, Venmo has become the largest consumer finance application in the US. Unlike other payment applications, Venmo is a payments platform built around its social capabilities. The platform encourages users to share their experiences after each transaction, facilitating conversation around their purchases. This high level of engagement acts as free advertisement for merchants. Fifth, Xoom is a PayPal service that allows you to spend money to your families and friends abroad. Xoom facilitates electronic fund transfers to over 158 countries worldwide via its website and mobile application. Xoom primarily generates revenue via a servicing fee and the difference in foreign exchange rates. PayPal acquires Swedish POS manufacturer iZettle for $2.2 billion in 2018. iZapso provides payment and point-of-sale solutions offering two distinct products, iZapso Go and iZapso Food and Drink. The iZapso Go application is free to download. It turns any smartphone or tablet into a point-of-sale system, facilitating cash, card, and invoice payments. Card payments through the app incurs a fixed transaction fee of 1.75% regardless of the card processed by the iZapso reader. Payment links, invoices, and transactions made via e-commerce websites incurs a fixed 2.5% per transaction made through the iZapso system. iZapso Food and Drinks allows users to track sales, staff, and waste, print orders, and split bills, in addition to all the features included in iZapso Go. Interestingly, you can scan the QR code in your PayPal or Venmo app. This is the way moving towards what really is a rapidly accelerating trend towards full omni-channel retail, where online and offline are merging together. PayPal is a platform that is incredibly well-suited for that trend. Finally, PayPal acquired Honey Science Corp in 2020 for $4 billion. Honey operates as a browser extension that aggregates and automatically applies online coupon to e-commerce websites. It operates a massive database categorizing the price of every item on retail websites and notifying users when there is a price drop on an item listed in their drop list. If a user makes a purchase from a select number of partner merchants, Honey receives a commission, which it then distributes a portion to its users via its cashback program. According to Reuters, on October 21st, PayPal will allow consumers to hold Bitcoin and other virtual coins in its online wallet and shop using cryptocurrencies at the 26 million merchants on its network. The new service makes PayPal one of the largest US companies to provide consumers access to cryptocurrencies, which could help Bitcoin and rival cryptocurrencies gain wider adoption as viable payment methods. So, PayPal stock increased by 5% that day. I've got the request from one of our subscribers, SH Kim, regarding stock comparison between PayPal and Square. I really appreciated your interest. So, I'll explain about Square business model first, and then provide a stock comparison between PayPal and Square by 10 stock metrics. Here we go. Square is a financial services and online payments company that provides hardware and software tools to help businesses run and grow their operations. Square business are divided into two segments, Seller and Cash App. First of all, the Seller segment includes Square's managed payment services, software solutions, hardware, and financial services offered to sellers. Square is available to businesses of all sizes and offers the most comprehensive free point-of-sale system on the market. As a result, millions of businesses use Square as part of their day-to-day operations. Second, the Cash App segment refers to Square's mobile cash application and provides financial tools to users of that app. It includes pay-to-pay payments, Bitcoin, and stock investments. The cash card is linked to customers' stored balances that can be used to make purchases or withdraw funds from an ATM. Here we have the chart that shows teen stock metrics for stock comparison between PayPal and Square. There are four notable questions as follows. Is this market growing? Are they good at this market segment? Is this company profitably growing? Finally, is current market price overvalued? First, is this market growing? Before anything else, according to Big Ideas 2020 by ARK Investment, digital wallet market grows by annual growth rate 27%. Both PayPal and Square play in this market, so green, green. Second, based on markets and markets, cryptocurrency market growth is 6.18%. Square started accepting Bitcoin payments way back in 2014. Its Cash App began allowing Bitcoin purchases in 2018. Like I said, PayPal and Venmo plan to allow users to buy and sell cryptos directly from both websites. Hence, both companies play in cryptocurrency market. So green, green. Next, are they good at this market? PayPal grows by 22% compared to the past year. This is less than the market growth rate 27%. Therefore, I put yellow. On the other hand, Square's revenue increased by 64%. This is greater than the market growth rate 27%. Digital wallet market grows exponentially, and at the same time, Square is very good at this market segment. Interestingly, Bitcoin revenue increased by 600%. So, I put green. Third, is this market profitably growing? PayPal's EPS growth rate is 87%. However, Square's EPS growth rate is negative 50%. Thus, I put green for PayPal and red for Square. Lastly, is current market price overvalued? PayPal's PR is 93 and Square's PR is 392. Moreover, PayPal's forward PR is 44 and Square's forward PR is 147. Accordingly, I put yellow for PayPal and red for Square. To summarize, based on Teen Stock Metrics, PayPal got 2 greens and 2 yellows, and Square has 2 greens and 2 reds. In terms of profitability and stability, PayPal is better stock. However, considering growth and momentum, Square is superior. In other words, for aggressive investors, Square is a better option, while PayPal will be more attractive investment alternative for stable investors. Finally, here we have the chart that shows my portfolio as of October 30th. Personally, I prefer PayPal stock to Square stock due to its stability and profitability. However, considering its price momentum, I've got 3 shares of Square as well as 3 shares of PayPal. For your reference, please find an attached Excel sheet showing Teen Stock Matrix analysis, chart analysis, profit and loss statement comparison, and qualitative references that I use for stock comparison. Today, I've discussed about fintech and investment ideas for PayPal and Square stock. In the next episode, I would like to talk about transaction as the first time in How the Economy Machine Works by Ray Dalio. Make sure to smash the like button below and comment down your suggestions for my future videos. Stay tuned and see you guys later in the next episode. Peace out.